Hey, what's up everybody? Alex back here again with another tip today. And today's video is one that I share with a lot of students, almost everybody I play with who plays competitive tennis. I think it's probably one of the most important things for people to know if you haven't heard about this before yet. I haven't really heard many other coaches or players or videos online that talk about this idea. So I'm hoping that this will really help you in your game, because I've seen it make a big impact on a lot of players that I've worked with in the past, okay? The idea, I'm going to sum it up, I like to call it being pleasantly surprised, okay? And what is this going to do for you? Well, this is going to allow you to hit more winners in your match, hopefully, than you're going to make unforced errors, okay? If I take a match stats, for example, and a player has 12 winners and they have 18 unforced errors, okay? They're at a -6 ratio from winners to unforced errors. So that's not that bad, actually. That's not that bad of a match. Sometimes you're going to find matches where a player has twice as many unforced errors as they do winners, or even a lot more than that. Even at the pro level, you're going to find that hitting more winners than unforced errors is not something that you're going to find in every single match. And a lot of players are actually going to end up hitting more unforced errors than they do hit winners in a match. Okay? But anybody at all levels, you can change that just by learning this idea of what it means to be pleasantly surprised. Okay? So again, let's take back the example of the player who hit 12 winners and who made 18 unforced errors. Okay? Out of those 18 unforced errors, let's imagine, because this is often going to be the case, that there were probably about 4 of those unforced errors that they made because, let's say, they ran around the backhand and they went for a big inside-out forehand trying to go for the winner, or any other situation where basically they missed the ball by about this much. They didn't really miss it by very much at all, right? Just a couple inches or less. And a lot of those, a handful, 4 or 5 maybe of those unforced errors could probably, were this far away from being winners. And so what's the difference? How do you turn those unforced errors into winners? Well, it's that idea of being pleasantly surprised, okay? I'm sure all of you have maybe experienced this at one point in your life when you're playing tennis, where you're hitting a ball and guess what? The shot was actually better than what you anticipated it was going to be, or that what you were trying to do with it, all right? And it ended up being a winner. The other player didn't touch it with their racket before the ball bounced twice, right? And you kind of were like, oh, well, that I was pleasantly surprised. I didn't mean to hit a winner necessarily there, but I did, okay? And that's the whole idea right there. If you get this idea down, and we take this example again, a player who hit 12 winners, 18 unforced errors, and I switch four of those. So those 4 shots that were out by this much, now instead they're in by this much, okay? Well, now all of a sudden I have 16 winners and 14 unforced errors. I have more winners than I hit unforced errors. And if you're playing a match where you have more winners than you have unforced errors, that's a pretty good quality match, no matter what your level is, okay? And no matter what the number is, whether it's 10 winners and 8 unforced errors, or it's 50 winners and 45 or 40 unforced errors, or anything like that, right? If you have a positive ratio of winners to unforced errors, that's generally a good quality match, and that's not easy to do. Even the pros you're going to see are not going to be able to do that very, you know, consistently day in, day out. A lot of pro matches, if you look at the stats they show you sometimes at the end of the match, you're going to find that not just the losing player, but even the winning player hit more unforced errors than they hit winners. They just, however they hit, their ratio is still a little bit better. Maybe the one who won is at like -4 or -10, and the one who lost is at like -20 or something, okay? But that idea of being pleasantly surprised when you hit your shot and seeing that it turns out to be a winner, that is key. Because what do you see, in my opinion, 99% of the players that I see going out there playing, usually what they try and do is they're forcing things too much, right? If you let go a little bit and you're just kind of concentrating on, you know, just playing good tennis, if the other guy gets it back, okay, no big deal. I know I hit a good shot. I made him work a little bit. I'm keeping the pressure on him. I'm taxing his legs a little, so I'm making him work. And you're not in that mindset of, I've got to hit this winner on this shot. Because a lot of times when you're in that mindset, what does that mean? That means you're not confident that you're actually going to win the point in the long run. And you're trying to look for a way out of the point. And then that's how you end up with more unforced errors than you do winners. Okay? So just remember that idea. I like to sum it up. Just remember the two words. Pleasantly surprised. Okay? If you're playing tennis that way, guarantee your game, you're going to be playing at a whole other level. Okay? Because some of those matches that you lost by just a handful of points, Well, those matches you can actually turn into wins, okay? And that's how the difference is made. No drastic other changes need to be made in your game. No big technical changes or anything like that. Just change that mindset a little bit, all right? Don't be going hunting after those winners too much when you're playing. And just find yourself pleasantly surprised when you hit them, all right? Let me know what you guys think about that, if it works for you, in the comments below. Any other topics or anything like that you'd like to see covered, let me know, and I'll try and get a video out there for you, okay? And we'll catch you next time.